I'm very happy to introduce our 53rd mayor of Waterville, Mr. Nick Isgrow.
Thank you all very much for coming tonight. Thank you for being here and being a part of this great moment, not just for myself, but for all of those that were sworn into office tonight. I do want to thank Amanda Essler for organizing this and everybody who was involved in the ceremonies. And I want to offer a special thanks, not just on behalf of myself, but on behalf of the city, to Mayor Karen Heck. Whether we agree on every issue or not, there is certainly no doubt to anybody that you love this city and you have a passion and you have worked tirelessly for 3 years, and I just want to say thank you. This is a very surreal moment to stand here, and I can't help, as I was trying to think about what it was I wanted to speak to you about, to think of some of my own family history and what it was that made me want to run for mayor in the first place. My mother's grandfather came to Waterville many years ago, and with little to no English on his lips, founded A.J. Carey and Sons, and along with my grandfather John, built many of the homes that our friends and neighbors still live into today. My grandfather John went on to serve the city of Waterville's code enforcement officer. On my father's side, my grandfather, Salvatore, as most people knew him, Sam, Isgrow, moved here in 1960 as part of a promotion with Scott Paper Company, and with him he brought his wife and 5 children, soon to be 7, all of whom graduated from Waterville High School, and I'm fortunate enough to live in the house that he built for them with my wife and 4 children today. He went on to serve the city as city councilor, and his son, my father, Jim, served the city on the city's planning board. And we know he must have been quite young at the time because he served as a Democrat. I kept thinking of these stories, and not because they are somehow special or make me special, but the reason I kept thinking about them is because these are Waterville stories. These are the stories that as you go around the city, you hear in every ward, in every neighborhood. And throughout the decades, people move here and find something that they love and hold on to. And with that, I do want to break a little bit. And I just want to read to you an excerpt from a letter that was recently found and given to me. And this was an open letter to the aldermen and city councilmen. It says, I don't think that anyone can dispute the fact that possibly all of the properties from the bridge of the Wyandotte could be purchased at a fraction of the cost of the property located at the proposed Charles Street project. A more important consideration is the loss of tax base would be very little compared to the $2,025,000 that we will lose as soon as the buildings are purchased through URA. Another reason, and the most important, is the human consideration. For less families and only a few businesses would be displaced, it is questionable whether the businesses would have to move. I fully realize that this plan is not as large in scope as the Charles Street plan, but I have never been aware of a rule that a big problem requires a big and drastic plan. I have been in business a few years and often have seen great problems solved by small changes. Why jeopardize the present tax base on a plan based on assumptions? I urge you to vote no to this plan. Respectfully yours. And this was written by my grandfather Sam in January of 1963 to the council here in Waterville. And so in there, what we see is that the issues that we face and we talk about and we debate are not unique to the time that we live in. And although we are in a new century where perhaps the solutions of yesterday don't apply today, the issues of progress versus taxes and the balancing of homeowners and commercial development are so fundamental to the building of this community, it would be naive not to view ourselves in a historical context. Well, that context today, we see new businesses opening on Main Street and elsewhere, people taking a chance on Waterville for the first time. We see existing businesses that have made it through some of Waterville's toughest decades. And although they look different today than they did 40 or 50 years ago, they've applied new technologies and strategies. That said, we also know that our manufacturing base remains decimated by forces far beyond the city limits. We see new families moving to Waterville and bringing new life to the community, but we also see dozens of for sale signs as people need to look elsewhere, perhaps for better paying jobs or simply a more affordable place to live. And so we do have our challenges, and as we try to come up with new solutions for a new time, and in a time that the mandated portion of the revenues that we generate remain under attack, the task that we take looks hard, and it is. And at times it can seem disheartening. But it shouldn't be, because if we look back and we see that these problems have existed since the beginning of Waterville, we know that when we come together as a community, the city always has come back stronger than it was before. And when we see these new businesses and these new homeowners, those are the new John Careys and the new Sam Isgros, and their stories are going to be told to their children, and they interweave, and we all meld into one pot, because our destiny, success or fail, is together. And so I'm going to ask you tonight to join me. We have the resources here in Waterville for great success, both material and human. But we can't do anything if we don't come together and work together as a community. And the message I want to give you is this, is that when it's easy to get caught up in the political fray, because there's going to be some tough decisions to be made. But when we do, remember that these people that you disagree with, these are our friends and these are our neighbors. So don't listen to the voices that would rather agitate than perhaps come up with a harder solution to the problems. Don't listen to those who would rather have a quick and perhaps what they think is a funny line that divides us, rather than listening ears that can come up with a solution to the problems that we face. It's very easy to forget in the political fray sometimes that Waterville's not just a place on a map. It's a place that we all love. It's a place that we call home. It's a place that we take with us wherever we go. And in each and every one of our hearts, it remains a shining beacon here in Central Maine. I thank you all for coming, and I ask you all to join us in this great work, and God bless you all.